Hey everybody. You're seeing red. This is Kim at her family farm in Cumby, Texas, and I'm here taking videos and pictures today of Sassy's bloodhound puppies, her 2023 bloodhound puppies. And the females. Female number one is the smallest. Female number two is a medium. Female number three was a little bit bigger. And I have female number four, and she's actually the largest. I don't know why I did it that way. I just did it that way. And it just happened to work out that way. So I have female number four in my arms, little black and, or she's not black and tan. She's a red with a black mask and a black tail. Very similar to the other ones. We have lots of helpers. No, it's not your turn. You already had your turn. It is your sister's turn. We are gonna get up here. Too many helpers. Hi, sweetheart. So this is female number four. She's a red with a black mask and a black tail, and she's the largest of the females. And over the years when I've tracked, quote, runts versus the largest puppies, although they might be bigger at the beginning, when they finish, the runts really are not much smaller. And I've had several runts that actually turned out to be the biggest dogs in the group. So it has more to do with where they're located in the uterus, and also which teat they decide that they're gonna get and dominate, because they pretty much come out almost the same size. Potty time, potty time. But then you have some that are like grab onto a teat that's closer to the back of her stomach and it has more milk, and then ones have the front closer to the shoulders and it doesn't have as much milk, and so they just grow at different rates. And down she goes. So anyway, that's the largest of the females. They're all sweet. They're all fun. They're all cute. They're all cuddly. And of course, I handle them daily. They come inside. They go outside. They're used to the TV. They're used to the vacuum cleaner. They're used to me cleaning the bathroom. So it's like a regular dog. They're used to everything. They're just not kept in a pen outside and just locked up for their whole life. No. No. And you guys get toys and you play with ropes and you play with balls and you play tug of war and all kinds of stuff. So they come from my house to your house and they shouldn't skip a beat. So nope. No, no, no. But they're used to getting lots and lots of love. Lots of handling. Lots of pampering. So these definitely are not dogs that you just adopt. Oh, you just leaped out of my arms. I just caught you. Please don't adopt one of my dogs. Stick it in your backyard or stick it out in a pen and leave it out there. These dogs are pack animals. They will cry and dig and drive you crazy and get in all kinds of trouble. Please, I love my dogs. Well, that was... What did you do there? What did you do? You fell on your face. I do love my dogs very much, and they are in and out of the house. They are part of the family, and that's what I'm looking for. I don't need a dog in 6 to 9 months that has no inside manners and has never been had obedience training or anything. That's just a recipe for disaster. So we just love these little guys, and we want them to go to very... Ow, that is my ankle! Okay, give me my ankle back. Okay, they are ankle biters. They are ankle biters, yes, and you still have your puppy teeth. All right, so now I'm going to attempt... Okay, that's... All right, that is my butt. Ow! Ow, that... Those were my shorts, and you really got a good bite there. Thank you, thank you. Nope. Mommy's getting up now. That hurt. So now I'll attempt to take pictures.